Hello guys, welcome back to the channel The Ultimate Divine Gaming. So this is the third episode of our Minecraft Basics series, and as you have got an idea from the title and thumbnail of the video, in this video I am gonna tell you that how to light a nether portal without flint and steel. For doing so, all we need is a nether portal, one lava bucket, two oak planks or any inflammable block of Minecraft, and a few dirt blocks or sand blocks. For making the nether portal, if you don't have diamond pickaxe, so there's no issues. We can easily make a nether portal with a few buckets of lava and two buckets of water. Yeah, you can see my previous episodes in which I have shown that how to do so with just buckets of lava and two buckets of water. Now we need to find an appropriate place for our nether portal. So I think this place is fine maybe. So first of all, I will make the nether portal frame. You can make nether portal frame of any dimensions according to you. I'm making it of normal dimensions. After seeing this episode and the previous episode of Minecraft Basics, you can easily make a nether portal and go to nether even if you are a beginner in Minecraft and you don't have diamond or flint and steel. Now, as you can see, our nether portal frame is ready. This is our nether portal frame. Now, we need to take some dirt blocks. Now, after our nether portal frame is ready, we will take dirt blocks and we will add dirt blocks at the lowermost obsidian block of the nether portal on either side, and we will cover it in a way, we will make a frame in a way so that if we place lava here, so the lava doesn't flow out. Yeah, you heard it right, we are using lava here to inflammate the block, because nether portal only works if we set fire in it. Like when we use flint and steel, it inflammates the nether portal and it sets fire. So that's why it works. Oh, I think I used the dirt block with grass. That's why this happened. Let me go into water first of all. Yeah, now we are safe. So let me tell you further that after, as you can see, I have covered it in a way that lava doesn't flow out. Now I will place any two inflammable blocks over it in this way. It can be oak planks, oak log, it can even be wool. It can be any inflammable block of your choice. I have here used oak planks because it is most easily available in my biome. And now here I will use one more dirt block like this, and then I will break this dirt block so that lava can flow out, and it will easily set fire on the oak planks. Now the oak planks are on fire, as you can see. It will soon activate the nether portal and we will be able to reach the, yeah, as you can see, it has activated the nether portal, it has lighted up the nether portal. Now we will take back this lava bucket. And if you wish, you can break these dirt blocks and decorate the nether portal. It's completely optional. If you want to do so, you can. So I am just a bit decorating the nether portal, and after this I will go in nether and show you that it actually works. So now we are ready to go to nether. I am entering the frame and going to nether. By seeing these last two episodes of this Minecraft Basics, you will be easily able to go to Minecraft in nether in survival, even if you have not got diamond or flint and steel. As a beginner, it would be very helpful for you. As you can see, we have reached the nether. This is nether, where we cannot place water, as you know, where water doesn't exist. You can see here, like, this is the lava, like the, this is all lava, this is lava only. Also, I suggest you that whenever you go to nether, make sure that you take something of gold, like gold armor or gold helmet or gold boots or gold shoes with you, so that the piglins who live in nether, they think that you are one of them and they don't start attacking you. Also, you are also suggested to take some other gold also, so that you can barter it from the piglins and get some good items. Now we are going back to our world. By bartering with piglins, you can get very rare items, and even you can mine a lot of gold in Nidor. So by seeing these last two episodes, you can easily go to Nidor with just buckets of lava and buckets of water, and you don't need anything else. Don't forget to like and like the video and subscribe the channel, and comment if you have any suggestions. Also, in the next episode, that is the episode 4 of the Minecraft Basics, I will show you that how to make an infinite cobblestone generator, and you will make this cobblestone generator with just, you will just need one bucket of water and one bucket of lava, that's it, and then your infinite cobblestone generator will be ready. In the Minecraft Basics series, I will show you to make various things in the easiest possible ways in Minecraft. So stay tuned for the next video. Hope you like the video, and thanks for watching.